Namaskar. I am Dr. Amit Dixit. I welcome you all to this MOOC on Enhancing Business Decision-Making Skills through Business Simulation. It is created by Banasthali Vidyapith for NRC to educate the teachers and the facilitators on the new areas of business simulation. Well, there are six highlighting points within this MOOC we will be discussing. The first would be demystifying business simulation. The second would be business simulation as a pedagogical tool of experiential learning. The third would be creation of virtual business reality. The fourth would be the benefits of business simulation. The fifth would be comparison of lecture textbook, case studies, and simulation methods. The last would be the role of an instructor. Before coming to the first point, I would like you people to know that the institutes of business administration are under continuing pressure to develop innovative courses to meet demands from the business community. At the same time, faculty members are facing increasing challenges in adopting innovative technologies because of the amount of risk and the effort involved. This MOOC facilitates the adoption of a business simulation as a purely experiential learning tool in an MBA program. The discussion today will help the teachers, trainers, and facilitators in adding value to the learning ability of students, hence making the MBA program more valuable. In the current scenario, the institutes of business administration are under continuing pressure to develop innovative courses to meet demands from the business community. At the same time, faculty members are facing increasing challenges in adopting innovative technologies because of the amount of risk and effort involved. This MOOC facilitates the adoption of business simulation as a purely experiential learning tool in an MBA program. The discussion today will help the teachers, trainers, or facilitators in adding value to the learning ability of students, hence making the MBA program more valuable. Now, let's come on to the first point, and we'll discuss it in brief, which is demystifying business simulation. Business simulation is the imitation of operations and management of real-world business processes, systems, organizations, competing firms, or an entire supply chain over time. In fact, Elgood, in the year 2011, defines business simulation games as a device through which individuals learn about how business and organizations work, and which enables them to improve their performance within their organization through the development of business or interpersonal skills. Business simulation tools are mainly used for educational purposes, typically practicing strategic, market, or operational analysis, logical or creative thinking, for rational decision making. It can help the students to learn an almost intuitive understanding of business, including a seamless integration of activities and processes and how management should work in the rest of the organization. Business simulation continuously reinforces the art of decision making through mental discipline by use of information to make decisions, considering the links between the decision areas, and strategic thinking. Now, let's come on to the second point, which happens to be business simulation as a pedagogical tool of experiential learning. A simulation is an experiential learning exercise in which students practice the design, implementation, and control of business strategies. They worry about the applications, not the definitions of business, concepts, principles, and methods. Decisions do not occur sequentially, but simultaneously and interactively, just as they do in the business world. The paramount objective is to help the students internalize business thought through the practice of business decision making. The more sophisticated business simulations, which may be labeled reality simulations, are designed to capture the qualitative and the quantitative dimensions of business decision making within the context of a total business enterprise. In these simulations, students have the opportunity to work either as top managers or as entrepreneurs. They must survey the market, identify and evaluate market opportunities, design and execute a business program, monitor their own performance and that of the competition, and adjust their strategies and tactics as necessary. Decision making, which occurs at the tactical level, includes business activities such as brand design, research and development, capacity planning, production scheduling, inventory control, media planning, and sales office management. Since all decisions are constrained by limited financial resources, the ability to manage the resources as well as the use of cash is critical to success. Let's understand the experiential learning model that makes the business simulation model more impactful. Now, if I go to the diagram and if I see that we all hold in our minds mental structures, which are ideas and assumptions. These influence our decisions about what to do and how to behave. Then we implement our decisions by actions. The consequences of actions link to a result, then have the opportunity to learn by adjusting or enhancing our mental models, thus completing the feedback loop and enabling us to make better decisions that are likely to produce best results. In the real world, however, there is a delay in the time of our actions and the time taken for the results to show up, which stretches the learning loop to enhance our mental structures. Business simulations are a short circuit between decisions and results for learning and adjusting our mental models. Now, let's come on to the third point, which is creation of virtual business reality. This simulation develops a living case in which participants create their own virtual business reality. The decision context is provided in the simulation software and manuals. The players provide the living details through their own deliberations, actions, and interactions with the competitors and with the market. Although the industry context does not change, the exercise actually represents a series of interconnected cases. In a sense, every decision period represents a new case and a set of circumstances. It might begin as a team building exercise that shifts to a market opportunity analysis case, then moves into a test marketing case, and finally becomes a market development case. At a later point, the need to develop an extended business plan and pro forma cash flows will put together many related decisions. As the industry and the firm mature, price and reliability become more important. At this point, the team's attention might shift to the improvement of factory operations via the use of common components, greater emphasis on product quality, reductions in line changeover times, and the use of different techniques for production scheduling. And of course, there is always need to fend off aggressive competitors. External market analysis further shapes the issues being addressed as team members try to understand how the market is altered by competitive moves, while at the same time assessing the impact of their own firm. Internal debates rage over an additional feature, a lower price, another salesperson, or a new media outlet, and the effects of these on consumer preference, competitive advantage, cash flow requirements, and profitability. As case studies, simulations are much more richer than decision outline found in any template or manual. It is the imagination and thought process of the students that fill in the details. The computer programs become simply a tool of organizing work and recording teams' decisions. Students do not need to role play, as the situation they are dealing with is in part of their own doing. The process of thinking strategically forces students to go beyond the immediate problem to consider their firm's future and how they want to shape it. Now, coming to the fourth point, which is benefits of business simulation. There are many benefits of using business simulation softwares. Few of them are: business simulations imitate reality. Our simulations emulate the real world factors and challenges that our organization faces. It gives your people a big picture to view operations by scaling everything down to a smaller scale. The second benefit of business simulation is a risk-free environment. The people will be able to learn from their mistakes in a safe environment and see the consequences of their actions across the whole organization without actually affecting your organization. The third benefit of business simulation lies in stimulating cooperation. By the use of business simulations, working in cross-functional team stimulates conversation and cooperation between colleagues. These conversations create peer-to-peer learning and open up your people to better understand the different perspectives in your organization. The next benefit of simulation is learning by doing. It is said that when we remember 10% of what we read, 20% of what we hear, 70% of what we discuss with others, and 80% of personal experiences. A business simulation allows your people to personally experience the consequences of all different aspects of business. Now, the next benefit of business simulation softwares is that they engage learners. Experiential, hands-on learning engages all the senses. Participants visualize, discuss, plan, receive feedback, and practice real techniques that they will use in the workplace. Now, the last benefit of business simulations is accelerated learning. A simulation provides a big picture view of operations, meaning that the participants are able to grasp a wide range of concepts and materials in a short period of time. By relating their new learnings back to their own company, stickiness increases and the knowledge follows back to the workplace. Now, I'll talk about the fifth point of the outline, which happens to be the comparison between lecture or textbook, case studies, and simulation methods. What I have done is I have compared these three pedagogical techniques on the basis of three relevant points, which are emphasis, content, and method of learning. Now, if I pick up emphasis and if I do compare lectures with case studies and with real life simulations, I'll talk about the textbook part. The textbook would always emphasize on the language and the tools of business. In comparison to the textbooks, the case studies would always rely on situational analysis, problem diagnosis, and strategic thinking. Whereas, real life simulations would focus upon business processes, execution of strategy, and management of tactics and teamwork. Now, comparing all the three different pedagogical tools on the basis of content, the lectures and the textbooks would always discuss the concepts, principles, theories, and analytical tools. If I talk about the case studies, they focus upon the decision situations, diverse scenarios, and contexts. If I talk about real life simulations, they'll make the user to learn about business processes, interdependent decisions, time-phased implementation, and continual adjustment. Now, comparing these three pedagogical tools on the basis of method of learning, the lectures and the textbooks emphasize on knowledge acquisition, sequential presentation of information. They are highly structured, and the right and the wrong is determined by the definition. And if I talk about the case studies, they make the student to focus upon critical thinking, sequential analysis, and right and wrong is determined by logic. Talking about the real life situations, the student is involved in real life decision making, management of interdependent decisions, and the overall right and wrong is determined by the outcome, and it varies with business conditions. Now, coming to the last point, wherein I would be discussing the role of an instructor. With simulations, the instructor's role, the traditional format, although lectures on strategy, competitive analysis, or cash flow may be warranted, the instructor's major responsibility is to serve the dual role of devil's advocate and a coach. As the devil's advocate, the instructor should challenge the team to thoroughly understand the dynamics of the market and the decision-making environment. During the regularly scheduled executive briefings, team members should present their analysis of the market, the decisions they have made, and their justifications for those decisions. The instructor's role is not to provide solutions to the team's problem, but rather to raise questions and issues that have not yet been addressed. As a coach, the instructor's role is to help students develop critical thinking skills. At the very least, the questions instructors ask during executive briefings should stimulate students to consider additional dimensions in their strategic thinking. Also, students come into meetings with the faculty with pointed questions based upon a need to know, much like their executive counterparts. The current situation can thus be used to illustrate concepts, principles, and theories concerning innumerable topics. To conclude, business simulation is an interactive mode of experiential learning, which should be used by every faculty to enhance the classroom delivery in order to bring life to the classrooms. I thank you all for watching this MOOC.